I feel pretty excited, pretty hopeful after so many years and so much hard work that we could be bringing forward a potential new therapy for Alzheimer's disease. I'm hopeful for the patients and what this means for them, and I'm immensely grateful to the team and the hard work that it takes to get this far. I've worked in Alzheimer's disease in the pharmaceutical industry for the past 20 years, but I'm a biochemist by training. And when I finished my studies, I focused my academic research on different mechanisms on how neurons die. Became quite the expert in how brain cells die in all sorts of different neurological disorders. And I learned a lot about, you know, a number of terrible disorders of the brain. And while that was fascinating and important, it wasn't really enough for me. I really felt that learning was great, but I wanted to do something about these diseases. And so I joined the pharmaceutical industry, and this is really where I want to be, the place that actually does something about those terrible diseases. Any filing, any submission of a drug to regulators is a major undertaking, and normally teams under those periods of time actually co-localize, work together. And so of course, during the period of the COVID pandemic, we had exactly the opposite. We had people working remotely from home and doing a really major task. We had the difficulty of people needing to take care of family members at the same time as trying to undertake this piece of work. We had to adapt our IT systems to enable us to work remotely, co-authoring massive documents from our respective residences and not on the, you know, company internet system. We also, unfortunately, myself and team members did also contract COVID and had to deal with recovering from and being able to come back and continue this kind of work through that period of time, and so that was an additional difficulty. All through this, we continued to engage with global regulators, the FDA in the US, the EMA in Europe, and PMDA in Japan. That kind of collaborative working made extra difficult by working remotely and in different time zones. I'm pretty amazed at the resilience of the team, but they really pulled through in this quite difficult setup. First, it brings hope to patients that finally there is a potential treatment that could slow the progression of their disease. But it also brings hope to a whole field of research that has struggled to really put together both the scientific concepts and the clinical development concepts to be successful. So what we have now is, from our work and undertaking, a roadmap of how it can be done. And so there are many others who can follow. I feel like we've put down the first brick in the road, and that road can now be paved. Well, at Biogen, we have a credo about working fearlessly. And you always hear these anecdotes about how major breakthroughs really take pioneering, leadership, resilience, and this is definitely one of those cases. This was difficult, and the team really worked incredibly hard. They followed the science, they put in the long hours, they were resilient to all sorts of aspects that unfolded as this story played out in front of them. It was an incredible effort. There should be among the team an incredible sense of pride of having looked at this scientific problem and continued to pursue it and push through, all, you know, with the aim of bringing forward a potential treatment for patients in need. The team did that, and there is nothing that is as rewarding as bringing forward something for patients who are in need. I'm incredibly proud of the team, and I'm very hopeful for patients with Alzheimer's disease.